In this video, we are going to learn how to evaluate a definite integral. Here we have three types of problem. First type is of the form integral over 0 to 2 pi f of cos theta comma sin theta d theta, where f of cos theta comma sin theta is a rational function of cos theta and sin theta. Then procedure to evaluate integrals in this type 1. Step 1, convert the given function f of cos theta comma sin theta in terms of z by substituting z equal to e power I theta. As theta varies from 0 to 2 pi, z describes the unit circle mod z equal to 1. Also, we know cos theta is e power I theta plus e power minus I theta divided by 2. That is equal to, we know e power I theta is z, so z plus and e power minus I theta is 1 by e power plus I theta, that is 1 by z, the whole divided by 2, that is equal to z square plus 1 divided by 2z. And also sine theta value equal to e power I theta minus e power minus I theta divided by 2i, that is equal to e power I theta values z minus e power minus I theta values 1 by z the whole divided by 2i, that is equal to z square minus 1 divided by 2iz. Then step 2, now substitute these values in the given integrand. The integral is transformed into integral over c f of z square plus 1 divided by 2z comma z square minus 1 the whole divided by 2iz dz divided by iz, where c is the positively oriented unit circle mod z equal to 1. Step 3, now evaluate the integral integral over c f of z square plus 1 divided by 2z comma z square minus 1 the whole divided by 2iz dz divided by iz using Cauchy's residue theorem. Using this type, now we have to solve one problem. The question is, show that integral over 0 to 2 pi d theta divided by 5 plus 3 cos theta equal to pi by 2. Solution. Now substitute z equal to e power I theta. Then dz equal to I into e power I theta into d theta. That is dz equal to I into e power I theta values z into d theta. That is d theta equal to dz divided by iz. Also, we know cos theta value equal to e power I theta plus e power minus I theta divided by 2. That is equal to z plus 1 by z divided by 2. That is equal to z square plus 1 whole divided by 2z. Now, the left hand side of given problem is integral over 0 to 2 pi d theta divided by 5 plus 3 cos theta. Now substitute d theta value and cos theta value, here we get, which is equal to integral over c d z by I z the whole divided by 5 plus 3 into cos theta values is square plus 1 divided by 2 z, where c is a circle mod z equal to 1. That is equal to integral over c d z the whole divided by, take this iz by denominator, so the denominator becomes iz the whole into 10z plus 3z square plus 3 divided by 2z. That is equal to 2 divided by I the whole into integral over c dz divided by 3z square plus 10z plus 3. That is equal to 2 divided by I the whole into integral over c f of z dz, where f of z value equal to 1 divided by 3z square plus 10z plus 3. Now using Cauchy's residue theorem, we can write 2 divided by I the whole into 2 pi I into sum of residue of f of z at each of its poles. Let us assume this is equation number 1. Now find the pole of f of z. Let us assume the denominator value equal to 0, that is 3z square plus 10z plus 3 equal to 0, which is a quadratic equation. And here the coefficient of z square is 3. Let us assume this is a. And the coefficient of z is 10. Let us assume this is b, small b. And the constant term is 3. Let us assume this is c. And we know z equal to, the formula is minus b plus or minus root of b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. Now substitute all these values a, b, c. We get minus 10 plus or minus root of 10 square minus 4 into 3 into 3. The whole divided by 6. That is equal to minus 10 plus or minus root of 64 divided by 6. That is equal to minus 10 plus or minus 8 divided by 6. That is minus 1 by 3 and minus 3. Therefore, 3z square plus 10z plus 3 equal to 3 the whole into z plus 1 by 3 the whole into z plus 3. Because here the coefficient of z square is not equal to 1, which is 3. So we can write this polynomial is equal to, first write the coefficient of z square, then into z minus first root into z minus second root. That is 3 the whole into z plus 1 by 3 into z plus 3. Therefore, minus 1 by 3 and minus 3 are the simple pole of f of z. And minus 1 by 3 lies inside of the given circle mod z equal to 1. But minus 3 lies outside of the given circle mod z equal to 1. Therefore, residue of f of z at minus 3 equal to 0. And we know if a be a pole of order 1, then residue of f of z at a value equal to limit z tends to a, z minus a into f of z. Therefore, residue of f of z at minus 1 by 3 equal to limit z tends to minus 1 by 3 the whole into z minus of minus 1 by 3. That is z plus 1 by 3 into f of z value. That is equal to limit z tends to minus 1 by 3 the whole into z plus 1 by 3 the whole into 1 divided by 3 into z plus 1 by 3 the whole into z plus 3. Which is equal to limit z tends to minus 1 by 3 the whole into 1 by 3 into z plus 3. That is equal to 1 divided by 3 the whole into minus 1 by 3 plus 3. That is equal to 1 divided by 3 the whole into minus 1 plus 9 divided by 3. That is equal to 1 by 8. Now substitute all these values in equation number 1. We get integral over 0 to 2 pi d theta divided by 5 plus 3 cos theta equal to 2 divided by I the whole into 2 pi I the whole into residue of f of z at minus 3 plus residue of f of z at minus 1 by 3. That is equal to psi I cancel. We get 4 pi the whole into 0 plus 1 by 8. That is equal to pi by 2. Thank you.